gonna do a quick video before the sun really goes down. It was delayed. Well, this is my jingle stick. I thought I should do a demonstration of what's in this, what I call the bigger bell. The bigger bell containing more big bells. Now, first of all, you can see the full length. There's a stopper, lots of bells. Here we go, closer. Now, this is a nice bell. I will be removing the screw that helps to hold the bell, the two bells. Well, give me a second. That wasn't supposed to happen. Excuse me. Right, there we go. It's easy to remove. It's very difficult to hold it. That wasn't supposed to happen. Right. Yep, I put usually like a rubber stopper with a metal stopper, like, you know, like a burger sandwich. Keep it there. Right. There we go. Move this. Now, underneath this IKEA container, which is considered a bell by accident, bigger bells, which I usually use when, like, let's say, for circles that I need a louder sound, like very un-Christmas like. And the other thing is, this came about because of these big bells. Apparently, a lot of people who held this stick when I first introduced, this wasn't there, and they love to do this. The scary thing is that when you sit down, it feels like this is gonna hit your head anytime. No one got hurt, but it was a potential. This came into mind, but it was experimental. Somehow it worked. The only downside is that once in a while I have to change this part, as it breaks often, as now the later batch of this container, the base is getting much thinner. Now there we go. Now you have a rough idea of what the jingle stick is made of and what's under that hat. Now, if I remove this off, let's say I just hold it, you can hear it a bit more Christmassy. Like, this is what I call my Christmas set. With the big bells, it's called the loud set. I think that's all for me for now. Thank you for joining me here. See you next time on the next video on how I actually play this or take this around walk for circles. Thank you. Alright, decided to do a part 2, but let's call this an epilogue. Alright, right now I have already removed the big bells off from my stick, so you get a more higher pitch sound for the stick rather than having the big ones with deeper. And yeah, it looks quite ugly. That's why for the epilogue, I'll be showing you how I put this back onto here. While there's still sunlight. Sunlight. There we go. This time I will do without this because I needed to take this off for a rehearsal this weekend. Now I'll make this lighter. There we go. I think I forgot how I did my stuff, but it's okay. It's much easier to do this without the head involved. Now let's see what my stuff is. Let's cheat a bit. Got my screw. I'm gonna poke through. Maybe this is a bit longer than my old screw that I used before this came in. Right. That is quite long. Well, it's just temporary. I doubt I'll be able to use this again, probably until the next drum circle or virtual session again. Hope you can still see me because this looks very awkward. Well, no matter. It's now worse than a bell. I've never seen this swinging wildly in my life.